This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
To you, wherever Wali or Wali Karamoja or Wali Moroto. Recently, we get a lot of calls from Bali, we get a lot of calls from Barara. Mwasize Mutia, how was your night? For me, my night was perfectly fine. And of course, the conversation is still going on. What is happening? What is causing the insecurities? And that's a big conversation on people's minds this morning. But today, we have a lot in stock for you. We have, of course, sports. And we have a conversation around someone who was killed in Makindye Court. Before that, I'd like to introduce to you who I have in studio. And on my right, I have Nick Nobat Rububi, a sports guy as usual. But today, I'd like to be taking over the whole show. And on my left, I have Imi Giwu.
Yeah, the girl from Pakwach, Junam.
Hey, how do they say good morning?
E-I.
E-I.
Or you can say Iri.
Iri.
Then you answer Arima Bell.
Arima Bell. Babu Zabacha Mulio.
Ah, Fituleke, Fituleba Wan, Fituleba Waganda, Waganda, Ugano Musinkana, Master Mutia, yeah, three, Manika Wena, Fituleba, very brief, main part, our Erota Purung, and you move on, life gets to one. But interestingly, by the way, about Ugandans in this country tend to go on so fast. When you, for instance, EG, or food day, or Kuzis, and Napu, Bissin and Napu, by the way, a few hours. And you know, people are back to the usual everyday, you know,
yeah,
activities.
Life goes on.
You mentioned the recent insecurity in the country, and I want to think that I think people have again moved on. Another death to happen. Hey, go to your food day, what must say?
So, another death. Already, another death.
So, I would imagine that I think the moving on part wouldn't be that bad, but how do we move on from, you know, from what happened yesterday or the other day to the next day? Because primarily, that could actually hunt you down in a way, you know, it happened to the other person, it could happen to you. Ninga Muslim Chavana Uganda, it's another new day, like I usually say, Days of Our Lives, 10th September 2019. It's a very gracious day.
Simu kasera katali kawamvu nyo tubuliro manyi ero siwo obato mumanyi atuja kwa tukuwa ka homework ugendo manyi ero siwo echalo choliko ino manya el siwo. But Imi, you had just before the show, you're taking me through some of the things that are happening around Uganda. So what we mwa
njagala nya abantu basigalenga bachali bulindara. We are not safe, okay? While the people who are supposed to be protecting us are doing the best they can, but also among them are the weevils, and also among us are the ones who are failing us security-wise. Ekitundu bakiyita buko. Waliyo omusirikale bamuse, omusirikale bamuta Wilfred Chemukuto. Bamuse emundu ye ne bagitwala polisi yakasibako suspect omu. Oyomu. Then aside ze zana, waliyo made bambi yabadde yakajokola. Embwa ze waka yazukso okukola emirimu gyaka kireka kufumba biki. Embwa nya nezimukako nezimuluma nezimutta. Era omwami bamunoonya nyinizo bamugambye agende ku police akole statement, bamuyita David Wakabi. Okitegeera? But you know, we take things for granted. I think it was an oversight. They might not have intended it, but when you're keeping such animals, you should know that anytime they can strike. Then
if you're a new member in the community, you've got to give
there's a kind of initiation ceremony.
No jireta. Obakati, what one name is that is a initiating. Just you do your due diligence, no yoko zisibira yo, no manyanti, abe waka, zebata manyi, zebata manyi, the dogs, the people that the dogs don't know are safe. Then also a massacre, basibia yabantu munana over a kidnap of a 7-year-old child. The child is called Bruno Tayebwa. Ye bacha akorachi, bacha munonya. Eruwero ewobulenzi. Still, four have been arrested over the kidnap of a 7-year-old child. Omwana bamita Amos. matovu ne bwetula ba ebintu bino byonna byonna then tuina ne nabasirusiru abagwagwa ngono musajja yawambi bamusanze Kabalagala nga mazo gamba abantu bamu kidnapping ze because ebitya ye kidnappinga rakubanga yagala kusenteza omuchara kati yagala omuchara sasule ransom katuina mweze embuzi wezi tyo serious things are happening but they are taking things for granted.
Those are money makers. So,
no, but Muslims are all the same.
So it goes back to the thing a couple of months back, I want to have a kidnapping just to get money out of their families. And you see, it's that desperate that makes you feel, you know, fall yourself in a bubble of stupidity. But moving forward, when you're going back to the events that happened, yesterday actually they raided a place that side of Makawempe division. Regards to Nagirinya is
murder.
Yes.
They cupped a couple of faces, including two women who were so in connection with the murder. And I think right now we're heading in the right direction. This should be hands on, you know. Mm. Let's go out there and find these criminals. But moving forward, the deaths are still coming.
Mulimu abagamba, oh, these girls are pretty. Oh, they cannot be. Guys! It's a fallacy. It's a fake mentality that we are having. Mbu omwana mulungi nyota inza kuwa criminal. Nothing beats those so-called cute girls at being criminals. Ochegera. Because simu yoyo omwana ono police go yakute. Her phone kept calling Nagirinya just moments before she was kidnapped. So police is still investigating if she's part of it, and we have people among us who are saying no, she's too pretty too. What is too pretty too? Like that myopic kind
have
of
you looked at her, have you looked at how Ari Nightway looks like? He's a good looking guy. He's a very
but
looking guy.
We shouldn't also be confused by looks. You look at a person. Let us vet. The same way a person at home vets the maid, ngagenda tandiko taking care of your house and your children, is the same way you're supposed to vet your partner. Bwakuwe namba, jikole ko saachi. But the searching. Don't just look at a person and say, oh, he's such a handsome guy. I like to have the. She's such a beautiful girl. No. Delve.
Oh, Willis, looks good. You cannot do that to me. What I pick from Giwo's conversations is a very sad incident of how a maid was killed by dogs and attacked by dogs. This brings me to a very short conversation I want to have with you guys. What's your take about having dogs at home versus having guard dogs at home? You know, there are guard dogs, and then there are normal dogs that you can train your personally.
See, that depends on your personal interest. I mean, some of us are not really friendly when it comes to, you know, animals. They say a dog is a man's best friend, but you see, that depends on how you want to define that. From what happened to that, you know, maid was very unfortunate, and I think it goes back to the owner, the dog owner. It's entirely up to you to make sure when you have dogs of such caliber, dogs that are very sensitive to new faces.
Yeah.
Usually they have cautions on walls. Be aware of dogs in this facility. That's for me is awareness to the new entrant. But going back to what you just asked me, I think I would prefer a normal dog that would maybe bark but not be so aggressive. Why? Because I'm in between. It will not attack, but at the same time, it will create noise that will, of course, let me know there might be an intruder.
Mm.
When you have a guard dog, its mindset is probably aggressive in that regard based on how it was trained. And for me, that
there are guard dogs that don't bite to kill. They just suppress that.
I've
seen the military dogs, though. They usually go out for areas whereby they will cause harm or
like the groin,
but they will not, you know, cause death. So in that regard, I think it's kind of two-sided. That would be a very good debate on whether you should actually have a normal dog or a guard dog. But moving forward, I think there should be a certain measure taken by dog owners.
Mm.
I think the person that actually sell those dogs, that we're selling you this dog, but it comes with A, B, C, and D.
And one of them is
causing death.
Causing death. Amy, what do you think about having a guard dog versus having a rokombwa ya kuchara?
I have always been a dog person. Growing up, we had at least 20 dogs at home. Ndiya chiyumba chalinga chinene orumo bwana wake langa kugenda kuruzinga baya mainja. But inevitably there were your original local dogs bunobumbwa ya kuchalo, some of them until I got bana yabanzi bile mbwa yange German Shepherd inga nene bweti, but it was raised to be a pet. What am I saying? It depends on what kind of home you're having and what kind of surrounding you have. Bobodi kuchalo nga abantu boba manye, you need to have a moderate kind of dog. Etegera abantu etagenda ku But there are also breeds that can be kept. Katinga Rottweiler, you cannot keep a Rottweiler at home.
Yeah.
Because they're such jealous and they just snap so fast. But then there are dogs that are trained. They have cues like Ojigamba Kwata. They always wait for their cues to attack. If you're a person with kids at home, there is also a breed that you're supposed to be having. You cannot have these big dogs that umwana agenda kujaza nyire ku mchira gwayo emurume they tear very because they spite very they attack very quickly.
What I think about dogs is I have dogs by myself. I would think that do not go for very trained dogs that you haven't participated in training. Own your dog and train it yourself. A dog is a reflection of the owner. If you're a lazy person, your dog is going to be lazy. It doesn't matter if you bought it trained or not. If you're a dirty person, your dog is going to be dirty. So, gulembwa yonge chali ncho, nto ojiigirize, awasolo kubanga we kumabungi. Moving on from that business at Makindye Chief Magistrates Court, temporarily came to a standstill yesterday afternoon when a man collapsed and died during proceedings in the magistrate's chambers. A man identified as Ephraim Kizito, about 70 years of age, a resident of Nabutiti Kansanga in Makindye Division, Kampala, was not a litigant in the matter. He had only accompanied his wife, Rosemary Kizito, for the hearing of her case. The wife was on charges of assault, and the case was before Robert Okupi, Magistrate Grade 2. Kizito, who sometime backstood surety for his wife, gently sat in a court seat in the chambers of His Worship Okupi, awaiting the hearing of his wife's case when he collapsed on his own and died instantly. Such a sad story.
Very sad.
Age coming through, maybe you also want to factor in maybe high blood pressure, because the wife is on stand. He might have gone through a series of moments in his head. At age 70, you can't really have surety that the person will actually can stomach or accommodate such pressure. But it's very, very sad to say that the man actually died, and we're here to see or maybe get reports on what could have caused the death. Could it have been something else internally? Maybe something from before. And even then, for the wife, you can imagine you've been brought in for a hearing, and then before you know it, your person who has been standing in for you, stroke husband, has actually passed on. So it kind of adds on the misery you already have as a wife and as an individual. But very, very sad moment right there.
Very sad.
And these court cases take a toll on anybody.
They do.
They take so long. And then the process itself is not clear cut. Uganda, there's something I'm hating with our people here these days. But a person in position to help you. Nadioka Gamba. Enjare Numa.
Well, that's the same.
But that's asking for a bribe. There's too much bribing.
I think that with the arrests of corruption, of course, recently we had an arrest for the gambling committee, the gambling board, where people are made arresting charges of corruption. I think that the anti-corruption unit is doing a lot of good work, and people down this side are also now scared to take jobs. Remember, the judiciary is under scrutiny, allegedly because of bribe and corruption. So I think that, these days we have a little less than we had.
Well, not too long ago, a very sister station, Bukit, they did a documentary, a spy out on the so-called bribes that do happen at judicial level.
Yes.
Even with the security agencies. And I think certain points were taken, and one of them was that you've got to be cautious on who deals with your case, who handles your case, and even then, how are they handling it in terms of response? Because then you can't rule out or you can't kick up the beat of them asking for something for you to be hired or handled. But in that regard, I think we're heading in the right direction. The anti-corruption is actually, I think, done fairly quite well to reduce the habit. It's a habit.
Well,
it's a disease eating up.
Maybe they've done something, but Willis, what we can do one say you say dinga ko wino gentle of gelok suburenga twin is abana na dada. Nasango mchala nga inachi baby che. So in passing na gamba mune, tonkubila kumwana angu uoburumi, ni mubuzo uoburumi batia. Na gamba na disi filideka wempe kudwari do. Nazariromwanange. She gave me her entire ordeal, but what I want to talk to capital on is the fact that eddagala lyomumalwaliro gyeriri lirina kubeera lya gavumenti lya free naye mbu abasawo bana bayitayita ku makya bonna especially the ladies bw'otamupasingira k'ebiri she was particular on ebiri nemubuuza how long ago mwana yenkana ki mwana wa myezi musanvu oyayitayita ow'eddagala bw'otamugamba musawo kwata zizino ebiri ne bakuba eddagala lya antibiotics. People are rotting in there because they're not bribing. It is not okay.
Na mugamba kuwe simu ya anti-corruption unit.
Guys, by the way, seriously, when you come across those corruption tendencies, where you know it is wrong, mukuwe anti-corruption.
Do you believe in having a dog home? And if you believe so, should someone keep a guard dog or should someone keep a local dog at home? You can give us a call and our numbers will be on your screen shortly. And you can also head over to our social media platforms and, you know, comment something up there. Nick, you have a shout out. Let's start with you this morning.
Our first shout out goes to police. That is peoples of, I won't finish that one. But yeah, police and Uganda Police Defense Forces. According to reports that came out yesterday, police and UPDF, that is Uganda People's Defense Forces, are coming out to launch a six-day exercise to register firearms across the West Nile sub-region to fight crime. Furthermore, Miss Josephine Agusia came out, the West Nile police spokesman, and said last week recently she courted witnessed shooting incidences that involved high-profile people in order to curb this crime. She added that this will improve monitoring and supervision of guns in the hands of private security organizations, civilians, police, and UPDF. Should such registered guns be used to commit a crime in the future, the details have been captured. This will also help us to conduct speedy investigations. And also, furthermore, Mr. Thomas Kamugisha, a police officer, said that the cartridges would be kept with experts so that investigations into cases of illegal use of guns are properly managed. He further quoted that we have just started this exercise, although Kenya is far ahead of us, but we hope to complete this exercise. Munanga Bazina, Abaina saying that they can afford firearms, thus, of course, licenses, which is about, I think, 5 to 6 billion. But I wouldn't want to have us civilians have guns because we've seen so many wars starting from domestic violence. Uganda has I think if they're going to legalize
we have very, very strong gun laws in Uganda, and we have people who enforce these laws in high top of, starting from the high position, of course, the lowest. And the other thing is that it's not really cheap to own a gun.
Definitely.
And also, obviously, and paying that yearly tax. But I realized recently that Ugandans are not allowed, as in civilians, are not allowed to have AK-47s as a type of a gun.
But can have the short guns.
You're not allowed to have guns that shoot rapid.
Oh, see.
So Okiriziwa. Okiriziwa. Poo. 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 Yes.
The ones that have, how they call them, those...
as long as it shoots, I think, more than three in a second, you're not allowed to have
them. So what are they trying to achieve?
No, those are some of the gun laws that Uganda has, and I think those, if put into practice and if enforced really harshly, Ugandans,
will
have
these
guns in public.
You see guys carrying pangas in public, broad daylight. You see a man carrying... I mean, it could be a farmer maybe going his way, but it's a panga, it's not even covered or sealed. And you're thinking, I might just bypass him and the traffic snaps.
No, the traffic laws, actually, you're not allowed to carry those sharp objects in public transport when they are not covered. Either if traffic officers stop the vehicle and they spot you, they will, I think, arrest you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you're not allowed to have them.
Interesting times.
Okay, my shout out today, Willis, finally, special needs to Ringa Bagenda Bavava Yoko, Mukisa Foundation. Children with special needs have got a new center at Busi Island in Wakiso District that will help them access medical and education services. According to the LC1 chairman of Jali Village Livingstone Musisi, the center will enable parents with children with special needs to take their children to the center for healthcare and education services. He said some parents who have been stigmatized will find it easy to access the center instead of carrying disabled children to 10-kilometer health facilities away. Some parents have been avoiding bringing out their children in public due to stigma, but since center is near their residence, this will help them take their children there, Musisi said. He said This is the first center to be constructed in Busi Island to cater for children with special needs. According to Florence Namaganda, the executive director of Mugisa Foundation, a baseline survey was carried out in Busi Island, and the study found that 180 children with disabilities had never accessed any medical services. This prompted the foundation, with support from Crane and Viva Child organizations, to construct a center that will benefit over 200 children with special needs in Busi Island.
Well, I think that's a good thing. There's always been a conversation about having some of these buildings, if you come, for example, to the city, to have them accessible to people with disabilities, people, you know, with a little bit of disadvantage. Mm-hmm. And it's a conversation that's been going on for quite some time. I hope that the Kampala City Council Authority could actually enforce it. There are some buildings,
do we have enough skilled persons to handle these special needs children? The only place I know, I beg to be corrected, is Chiambogo University, that offers study courses for
people
special
with special needs,
needs.
Yes.
Or how to handle these people. But nabona mu categories abo chitegera. So I am hoping that this will they will give avenues for training people. I don't think it should only be people who are going to handle these children. I think everybody needs to be interested in how they handle children with special needs. Katinga badef, bawa courses, surely you can take your kids during even holidays, but you get to sign language. Bagende, basome, Chiambogo also gives courses, short courses for even senior six children.
The basic courses.
Basic, eh?
I think they're important because, you know, you never know when you need to communicate
then
with someone.
Then we shall deal with the stigma. No manyanti, these people are just like us. They're not any different. They can be our friends. We can talk to them and have a professional talk, argument. Really, but this is a very good move. I like it.
All right. In that light, I would also love to shout out this morning to Victoria University. Why? Because the privately owned Victoria University is to roll out courses in artificial intelligence and robotics. Speaking at the university's fourth graduation ceremony at Munyonyo Commonwealth Resort on Friday, the Vice Chancellor, Mr. Kishna Sama, revealed that they will be introducing the specialized courses soon. Mr. Sharma said the facility is working round the clock to bring in real training possibilities in the areas of artificial intelligence and robotics, information security, and computer forensics. On this, once this is put into effect, the institution will come off as the first university in the country to offer the said courses. I think this is a good thing. We'll have people learning, you know, you'll be able to detect.
You know, many years back, they were saying that.
To be creative,
yeah.
And probably create a simple robot.
Or whatever.
To replace our own, like, house managers. We have a robot. So it kind of kills employment in a way.
It doesn't.
If you go deploy machines, we've seen this in the movie.
Ofunaka robotiko wali ewo ku kitchen.
Atari Samantha.
Ngagwe teka utesi chikopo. Samantha rush to move back. Oteka mutesi chikopo karobo ni kateka musukari majani.
Olaba wilise, tuja kukiriza anti, abana masomyo tubayigirize particular things to mold them differently. Katinga in this regard, if they have children coming with coding knowledge from wanseno. By the way, guys, coding is something. Okay, it is simple. I've been reading on how to learn and teach my own kids. But it's basically what we do every day. Everything you do every day is coding. No zuka kumacha, no senya manyo, no nyachai, no tambra koko. All that is coding because there is a sequence you follow. But now it just comes to the zeros and ones on the computer.
Neno za tuanditandi kideri wansi. Edda, ngafetukula. We used to make the wired cars and the wired bicycles. Then we used to talk about our people. Ngatamani. Ngatamani kola dole ya biaya. Ngatamani kola kasepiti mukakebeka kablu band.
Yeah, work as this.
I think now we find the practical education syllabus. Ngamazo kore, you know, when the minds are a bit older. But.
But we used to make these cars when we were kids. When we were about 5 years, 6 years, you're making a trailer.
I think in the long run, they've got to change the way the education syllabus in the country is being portrayed and being laid out. Because many of us were told how to pass exams, not how to, you know, how. how to get the best out of us in terms of the real world, you know. I've been told 1+1. How is that going to help me tomorrow when I'm actually looking for a job? Mm. And there's been so much debate around what should be taught to kids when while at primary level, at secondary level, thus moving into, you know, my university. So I think for me, as an individual, I'd love to have my kid being taught things that will help them in the long run, things like
Jemikono, as opposed to Saskatchewan. Remember today, if you believe in having a dog at home as security, would you rather have a guard dog or a dog for yourself to train? Now, if you haven't got yourself a copy of the new vision, after 3 seconds, we shall be taking you in what's happening in some of these dailies around Uganda. We start off with a new vision today morning. Simanyo Nicholas Rubia Naso Rabukid. Metu Jakulwana Mpola Mpola. In the new vision this morning, front page, they are bringing you a Nigerian story, and they are saying police bust killer cell. 6 suspects arrested as probe widens, and the detail of that story is on page 4. Plus, of course, in the front page, there is Nigerian's photo, and of course, I think 2 suspects here, Hussein Kasoro and Johnson Rubega, who were arrested on Sunday night at Mabito near Natete police station. A story chagina maso nyo. Kupeja yokusatu, fake government stamps have been recovered. And this is because a joint operation by police and immigration officers have busted stamps cartel of fraudsters in Kampala, dealing in forged high-level stamps and seals. Peja yokutano, new cancer drug to be introduced. New vision equade details are, and over 20 accused government of torture and illegal detention. The story, remember, yesterday we were talking about how parliamentarians want access to safe houses. And of course, that's the story that New Vision is covering. On page 7, Mbale Woman MP security enhanced over death threats. Just the other day, we saw, I think, a magistrate who was sent empty bullets in an envelope.
Death threats.
Yes, katuwali wono no MP. Bamugambi bagala mulia. Kupeja yomwenda, siblings fight over 28 acres in Watiso. Get yourself a copy of the new vision to find out details of that story. And if I rush through the paper, of course, there's a pullout here. Oil and gas. I keep telling young people, banai musoma mafuta. So mama futa ni osoma ka certificate in 2025. We shall start, of course, drilling our oil. Public debt to soar as oil deals fail to take off. Of course, that's in relation to the financial investment decision. The conversation has been pushed, and of course, to next year, if I'm not mistaken. Dubai economic slump to persist to 2022. Nick will be telling us when the World Cup will be happening, United Arab Emirates. And of course, in the international news, in the new vision, Mashar in South Sudan in a bid to salvage peace deal. And if you go to the back page of the new vision, they have the sports there. And saying what's up with open title, what US open title means for Nadal and Aviv armed for October 6th. That and much more in the new vision this morning. Of course, let me move over to Imi to give us what's up.
And in the monitor today, what a story, Ken, so okay, deko kwa, no? In the monitor, 5 don'ts before you say I do. Avoid lying about your debt. Avoid busting your wedding budget. Don't buy more homes than you need. Yes, one home is enough. Don't go it alone. Touch kora weka. Don't wait to invest. Yeah. And another story in the monitor that you might want to read. There is letters here. There is someone saying emergency response needs regular practice, not just a one-off. We must address causes of crime. What on the street? What lessons do you learn from Robert Mugabe's legacy? Great man gone. Commonwealth Women Parliamentarians branch to discuss the rights of female lawmakers. Uganda. How Uganda has benefited from the Commonwealth. There's a lot has been written here that you can learn. Government to cancel passports over fraud. Please get the monitor and read about this just in case you're going to suffer it also. Nabagereka launches drive against child sacrifice. Why aren't you saying anything about child sacrifice?
Do I look like a child?
State House probes death of Ugandan workers in Kuwait. How CIA used music to spy on Uganda. Music choice. Banai mufune monitor stories zino nange ngenda zeso mera lero.
Tudekewa niki mubuke de tulabe.
Mubuke de lero na mubuku bili septemba nga kumi mwaka mkumi bili mkumi bili
mkumi na mwenda.
Mkumi na mwenda. Well, headlines zika amanti. Who know? Era wana waga amanti. Yara weke demo katambi ka okuta nagiri nya. Mbamu kute. Ila ifana hezo chi wano. Mubuke de lwa lero. Anusu kumi woka. Otuna mupeje zema se waga amanti. Atonde. Engeri je barondo de abagi
Aniawasani.
Bewasa.
Atuleke munawe. Asabaka awadde aze okulira omuso omusango gwa muchara we na akuti awa. Atukide mu koti. Yono musajja.
Akutukide mu koti.
Ayakutuse mu koti. Etemu ku lwe entebe. Abaga amanti ya kamera kamera ziraze entabula yomotoka. Yabagenzi
ntambura
yone bozi wane gamba anti embwa za zitaiza omukozi wa waka nezimuta ensonga yajogeddeko Museveni asuubiza okwongera abavubuka sente bannanga Wolf Creation agenda kitikino kwa abavubuka be
nange ndi muvubuka munaye
abanoonya bannanga bali wana baga musajja alina omukazi tonkubira simu be babanyonya wana bachala Abaga love super muti ya yune.
Wegede leze nyoru gada kweni.
Of course, buke dilu paregane esanyu di abade ojo utaro tufuka. Tukufa mikole. Abakazi wano beto ojo utaro. And of course, in the sports section, puresa. Eri express mkwano kwa abandi. Bagina samba, bayinu mpira, odoku wencha. Bagaluzi nge mpire, satu. Agulo papalo ulo kere kunosu. Kumi waka unakulo ulo kubili September. Kumi pili mu.
Kumi na mwenda.
Why isn't anybody saying about the motorcare people? There's a guy that died. Now there's another lady who has been kidnapped.
Yes.
Like, why is there a sequence there?
Ba mafia ba ingi dego ndi company yo. Nega chayera kwa mafia, remember that I asked you something just when the show had started. Do you believe in having a guard dog at home? Head over to our Facebook, Aban TV Uganda, or our Twitter, Aban Television. And of course, we have comments here. Thank you very much, Gilbert Atibuni, for watching Aban today. We head over for a short break, and after that, we have a group of very young people who are Aban TV ambassadors. Watch out for their aspirations.